अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास, वेलकम बैक। सो नाउ वी आर स्टार्टिंग अवर न्यू चैप्टर विच इज एक्चुअली सिंक्रोनस मोटर्स। सो इन द लास्ट चैप्टर, द लास्ट टू चैप्टर बेसिकली वी सम स्टार्टेड विद द बेसिक्स ऑफ द एसी मशीन्स एंड वी डिराइव डिफरेंट फार्मूलाज फॉर द इंड्यूस वोल्टेज विच वॉज फ्रॉम द अर्लियर चैप्टर। Then we derive the formula for the torque. Okay, and basically we use these formulas, okay, for the synchronous generators, and we modified this formula to the BR times the net B, right? So basically in synchronous generator, okay, what we were doing, we were converting the mechanical power to the electrical power, right? So we have the stator and the rotor. It was being rotated by a prime mover, okay, and eventually we get the electrical power at the output, right? That was the synchronous generators. So now we are going to study the synchronous motor. Synchronous meaning is same as was in generator, that the electrical frequency will be locked with the mechanical rotating frequency, okay? Okay, that concept is same. So the only difference is, okay, so as in the generator, you were converting the mechanical power to the electrical power. So in the motor, we are doing the reverse. We are converting the electrical power to the mechanical power. What does this mean? This mean is, this is, for example, this is your stator, this is your generator. The configuration are similar, okay? The configuration of the generator and motor are similar. Okay, the only difference is, in generators you are rotating this rotor, okay, and we were getting electrical power at the windings of the stator, okay, but now in the motor case, what is actually happening, okay, you will be supplying power at the coils of the stator. We were supplying the three phase power, okay, and we were also supplying the field winding, okay, supplying the DC power to the field winding of the rotor. Okay, now basically this supplied three phase power, okay, it will induce the stator magnetic field, and this stator magnetic field will cause the rotation of the this rotor, okay, mechanical rotation. So basically this electrical power, it will be converted to the mechanical power of the rotation, okay. So when we apply DC power, okay, to the, like the field current to the winding of the rotor, okay, there will be a BR, right? So we know that the combination and the cross product of the BR and the stator, or the net magnetic field inside the stator, okay, the torque will be induced and eventually the rotor will be rotating, okay? So that is the concept, the difference between the generator and the stator, and that is the purpose of this chapter. So we will be studying some basics, principle of the motor operations, okay? So basically this is a kind of a reversal of the generator. So if you understand the concept of the operations of the generator very well, okay, this chapter is like a piece of a cake, okay, if you understand it, the concept clearly, okay, because most of the things will be reversed. Almost everything is reversed, okay. We will stay after the basic, we will take the steady state operation of the motors. We will see that like in steady state, like if you are changing the load, okay, then how the operation of this motor will be affected. So like in the generator, we have seen that if you change the load, okay, the real power and the reactive power, okay, those changes based on the load characteristics, okay. And like in the parallel operation of the generator, we have studied this thing in details, okay. We will see the similar things here, that if the load changes, then what will be the effect, and actually how we can actually start the synchronous motor. That is actually the third chapter. So in the first part of the lecture, we will try to cover the first two parts, and the second part of the lecture, okay, we will try to cover these two parts, okay. And the last part will be the, like, what is the actually main, how we can summarize the differences between the generator and motors. So let's start with the basic principle of the motor. So as I said earlier, okay, the configuration is similar. You have a stator, So, but remember, most of the time in the books, in the literature, okay, when we are actually using referring to the motor, okay, so stator is also called as armature. And most of the time, when we are referring to the motor, we use the term armature, not the stator, okay? So that is the difference here. And so basically what we are supplying the three-phase power here, and it will result in the torque, okay? Because we are having the two magnetic field here, one is the BR, one is the BS, and there is the cross product of these two. It will produce the torque, and eventually it will result in the rotation of the rotor at a synchronous speed, okay, W synchronous, which is synchronized with the electrical frequency, okay? So that is the basic operation. So the major thing, okay, the important thing is, if you guys remember, in the generator case, this was our rotor. And for example, if this was your rotor magnetic field, okay, your stator magnetic field was actually lagging the rotor magnetic field, okay? And eventually you have the net magnetic field, okay? And so basically the BR, okay, so it was lagging, but here in this case the stator magnetic field is leading the rotor magnetic field. So I will explain this thing in the coming slides, that why. So this is the one major the starting difference here. So in the generator, the stator magnetic field was lagging, but in the motor, the stator magnetic field will be leading the rotor magnetic field. Okay, we will see that how why it's happening in the motor, and how it will affect the impression, okay, in the coming slides in detail. So that is the first difference. The second difference is, like, we want to talk about the equivalent circuit, okay? So basically the synchronous motor is same, as I'm repeating again and again, in all respects of a synchronous generator, okay? Except for the direction of the power flow. In the generator, you are getting the mechanical power converting to the electrical power. So in motor, you are getting the electrical power and converting to the mechanical power. Okay, so for example, if in generator case you are getting the mechanical power, getting electrical power, and that was your armature current direction. So in the case of the motor, what will happen? The only difference will be this current direction will be changed. That is the only difference. So the circuit model which you have developed for this generator, it will be the same for the motor case. Okay, the only difference will be, in generator case, okay, the direction of the IR measure current was this one, okay. So in the motor case, the direction of the current will be reversed because the power flow is reversed, okay. Rest of the things will be same, okay, exactly the same case, okay. You have the the rotor field circuit, you are supplying DC power, you are getting the field current. Okay, so eventually, so basically in generator, what is happening? The field current is becoming the cause of the flux, and the flux is generating the internally generated voltage, and that is actually finally becoming the cause of the output flux. Okay, but here you are providing this thing. You are providing this thing. Okay, and you want to generate this thing. Okay, so that is the reverse flow. Okay, so if you want to write the equation for this case, so the equation will also be same. For example, V phase, it will be equal to IA times RA, voltage drop here, plus the voltage drop across the reactance. So IA times JXX plus this voltage drop, yeah, right? That is the same equation which we have developed. So the only thing is the change in the flow, the change in the current, okay? That is the only difference here. Okay, so if you want to calculate EA, so just take all these things in this side and you can calculate the EA, okay? So this is the per unit, per phase circuit, equivalent circuit, and for the three phase, okay, V phase 1, V phase 2, the circuit will be similar, okay? So the circuit are also similar, okay, for the synchronous motor, okay? So far, it's going easy, okay? Now, in the start, I have told you that the difference of the BR and BS in the generator, BR and BS. Now, let's see in detail that why the BS leads the BR in the motor case, okay? So, Before going into the details, let's review the phasor diagram. Okay, we use the phasor diagram because understanding of the concept using the phasor diagram is quite easy. Okay, so can anybody guess for which case this phasor diagram is for the generator? So this is the phasor diagram of the generator, but for which case? Okay, so you know that the current is lagging the voltage. Okay, so basically this is a phasor diagram for the lagging power factor case. Okay, what is the lagging inductive power case? Okay, so this is the simplified phasor diagram with the armature resistance equal to zero, right? So the only we have the reactance part here. Okay, so and this is the phasor diagram for the voltages, and this is the magnetic field diagrams, if you guys remember. Okay, that more simply, that was my rotor. If that was my BR, okay, then this was my B stator, and I was getting the B net here, right? If you guys remember. So basically BR is producing the internally. So BR, finally the rotor becoming the cause of the producing the internally generated voltage. BS, okay, is actually producing the voltage drop across the stator, right? So minus JX into IA. And the B net is basically was becoming the cause of producing the output voltage flux, right? So that was the basic relationship. Okay. So this the magnetic field relationship is more simply is drawn like this one. Okay, that the BR is basically leading the BS, right? And the angle between this one, it was theta. The sigma. Okay. Sorry. So and if you guys remember. So if you want to write the induced torque, so the induced torque was the K times BR. Okay, what was the formula? With the B net, right? In the case of the generator. So the cross product of the BR and the B net. Okay, so if you take the cross product of the BR and B net, okay, so basically my induced torque was in the clockwise direction, right? The clock direction is this one. So the induced torque, the cross product of BR was clockwise direction for this case, right? Now let's try. Okay, so so this was the normal operation of the generator, right? For the lagging case. So in the generator, what was you doing? Your rotor, it was being rotated through a maneuver. Okay, well, let's consider the same case. Okay, let's say we are having this magnetic field diagram. Okay, we are having the clockwise induced torque. Okay, now let's assume that the prime mover has suddenly stopped. Okay, motor the rotor was rotating. Okay, with the synchronous speed of omega m or omega s, whatever you say, and prime mover is suddenly stopped. So if the prime mover suddenly stops, then what will happen? Okay, the two things will happen. First thing will be your rotor, it will slow down, right? Your rotor will slow down. So rotor slow down, okay, what will be the result? Okay, the rotor magnetic field, okay, when rotor slow down, it means the rotor magnetic field of the rotor, it's also going down, okay? So it will also reduces. So eventually what will happen, our net magnetic field, okay, it will reduces, right? So eventually what will happen, so basically if this is your net magnetic field, because the rotor is slowed down, so the magnitude of the rotor magnetic field is going down, okay, so it will actually become lesser than the B net magnetic field. Okay, so it will come down, the the BR will come down here, okay, and PS, okay, the stator magnetic field, okay, because it is rotating with the it is being produced by the stator, okay, so BR will fall behind the net magnetic field, okay, and BS will goes up. Okay, so that is actually the reason. Okay, that y in the motor case, y in the motor case, your BR is actually lagging the BS. Okay, so basically this will become my sigma here. Okay, and now if you try to calculate the torque, so torque is what? K BR cross product of B net. So now if you take the cross product of the BR and B net, so this is BR and this is my B net, so the torque will be my counterclockwise, so torque will be like this one. Okay, here if you remember, your torque was clockwise. Okay, so in the generator you are getting clockwise torque, but here now you will be getting the counterclockwise torque. Okay, so due to the slow down motion of the rotor, magnetic field of the rotor will slow down and eventually it falls behind the net magnetic field. Okay, and this, so when it falls behind the net magnetic field, so basically stator magnetic field becomes the NED. Okay, the second thing, okay, the direction of the current will be inverse. Okay, now for example, if it is lagging power factor in the case of generator, so in the motor case what will become? It will become a leading, right? In the motor case it will become a leading. Okay, so let's say, so this is the change of the magnetic field diagram. So now if this is the direction of the current in the generator case, okay, so basically in the motor case what will happen? Okay, so if this is my V phase, okay, now the current has become leading. Okay, direction of the current has been changed. Okay, now this has become leading. Okay, so in the leading case, basically we will get the EA. Okay, and that will become my JXS into IA. Okay, because the direction of the current is reversed. Okay, so that will be the phasor diagram for the motor case. Okay, reversal of the generator case. If it is generator is acting as a lagging power factor, so in the case of the motor it will become a leading or the capacitive case. Okay, so that is the basically difference. So if I want to summarize all these things, okay, so these are the actual phasor diagram.